Okay, so.
Oh, the top ones too?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
So these are our columns. And we're going to faux them to look like this. Okay, so Tina's using crud cutter to clean it. We've got all our tarps down. And we'll keep prepping. Okay, so we have damage on the columns where it's cracking all up here. So to patch it, I'm gonna take a Dremel. Because if we just keep patching over it with plaster, it'll just keep cracking. So I need to make a groove. And I'm just... And this is not the best Dremel, but... Wow. It's doing the job. See, so this way... I can plaster that, and so I'm going to follow that all the way down. So then you just.
Oh, you just wait. The dollars ain't got. There we go. Then there's a little more light.
I'm just going to fill these with some plaster. Actually, aquastone.
This is okay. Here's some more light.
Thank you.
And let's see.
This light. Is this up? So everything's prepped. Tina's taping off. Plaster is drying. There's some shock there. Okay. Just perfecting my color here. So I have no idea why my glazes are so thick on this.
The what?
Look how thick my glazes are.
Are they supposed to be?
I don't know. I love it. I mean, it's nice to be this thick, but I don't know
how.
It's that enamel, that waterborne alkyd paint that I use on cabinets. So I think it just, I love it. I'm going to.
Okay.
So this is just water. All I'm doing is I'm dampening my sponge so it's pliable. I don't want any water on here, so I'm bringing it up tight. I just want it pliable. Okay, so this is like, seriously, like the easiest technique ever. So I'm gonna dip my sponge in my glaze, and all I'm gonna do is swirl around. I don't want the sponge pattern to show. So I'm just tapping if there's like a funky little seam. That, like I don't want that there, so I'm just gonna. And this is very light, intentionally, because what I'm gonna do, when you have like stone, any earth element, there's a depth to it. Like, you don't want it just to look surface painted. We wanna build it on to kind of create that same depth. Look of the depth. So even though you can hardly see this, it's intentional because this is just the first coat. And again, my pouncing and padding is just to kind of get rid of any lines. Some of them. Yeah, maybe it is. Okay, so this area with the grooves, I obviously have to fill in the groove with my brush, and then I'll just kind of pounce Actually, I'm going to kind of cross-hatch it a little. Because I don't want it just to look painted. And then I'll take the clean side of my sponge and just kind of tap it just to pull some off so it's mottled. Yeah, I think that's good for now. So I'm going to continue this throughout. Okay, so first coat on four of them. Have that one up there. Second coat. Same thing where I'm gonna do a little more twisting. So I'm going to get my coverage, but I want kind of, you see?
A little bit more color on it that way when you do it?
Yeah, so the underneath is going to give me shadows, highlights and shadows. And then just kind of twisting is going to give it, you know, I don't want to see a complete pinwheel like that, but I'm kind of twist, so. Whoa. Can you see it?
Yeah.
So I'm just gonna follow that way through. And I'll get some of the other side so we can see them merging. So these dark marks, I'm gonna blend. Some of them, we go back to our little padding. Okay, so you still see some movement, and you have some light and dark, so there is movement, but it's just getting smoother with each layer. So this is layer number 2. Good?
Good.
Day 2 on our columns project. I just wanted to get a view of this beautiful house and see the architecture and why we're doing what we're doing. This house is just lovely. Let's see.
Good morning.
So let's see how the columns look today. Oh, they look beautiful. All right. Look at this handsome one. Hello. Hello, lovely. Hi. I know. We have to keep you out while we work. Hi, beautiful. Okay. Thank you.
So there we go. Can you set them up? Look at this beautiful house. And this is faux marble. Faux marble and silver leaf. Yeah, this is what we're dealing with here. Beautiful, beautiful. Okay. Let me get to it.
Okay, so what I'm gonna do, this is empty. I'm going to not measure, and I'm just gonna kinda wing it. So I'm just gonna put a little bit of glaze. This is just white paint. It's around 50-50, but you know, no, maybe it's not. It's a little more glaze. I'm gonna put just a touch more. Okay. So now this is filling. This, okay, I should probably have a mask on. I'm going to hold my breath, but this is a texture. This is what you add to paint to turn it into suede. It's called it's a suede texture. So I'm just going to. I'm only making a little smidge in here, but look at that. It's so fine. So you don't really want to breathe it in. Now I put a lot more in here. It's probably equal to the liquid. All right, let me breathe. Okay. Yeah, you don't see it there? And so I'm just going to...
Oh, yeah, it's not a lot.
No, because I'm going to add it to... Actually, I had some remnant in there, and it's hard. Because this is too liquidy for what we're doing. And the aqua stone, which I always use, is too thick. So I created this in the samples, just trying to achieve a certain look. So that's what I came up with. And it achieved it, so. Oh, there, I'm breaking it down. Okay, so then I have my aqua stone. This is what I mixed up for the sample. And what that is, so essentially I'm mixing up what's in there because that's not enough for all six columns. So what I'm going to do, this is aqua stone. It's a gridded plaster. I don't think that's going to be good for now, but this is also what I use to patch up the cracks and flaws.
Is that something you mixed up yourself, or that's a product?
This aqua stone is a product. It's by Faux Effects. So you can't just get it at a paint store. You have it's a faux finishing product. Okay, so now I'm gonna mix my concoction here. So what it's doing, this alone was too liquidy and it didn't give me the texture I wanted, but this was just too firm, and I couldn't get it achieve the look we needed. So I'm gonna tried thinning it with water because it's a water-based product, and it got just too runny, so I was like, I need to maintain the grit, which is why I got that suede grit. So, okay. So, which
one?
Yeah.
I meant to say that to you before you got your gloves on.
What?
I would suggest back.
Yeah, right. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is wet my sponge so it's pliable. I don't want it wet. I just want it pliable. So I'm squeezing everything out of it. So now it's pliable. Also, the sponge was smooth like this, and I cut chunks out of it because I want it pitted. We want this to look like stone. We're doing a travertine. So, all right, that's all that water was for, is just to wet it. Now I'm going to, this is the plaster that we mixed. Again, this is aqua stone and a suede grit mixed with a glaze and a little touch of white paint. Because I do want it white. I do want, when I glaze over it, that white to kind of show through. So, okay, so I'm gonna wet my sponge. I mean, get the plaster on my sponge. And we're just going to blotch it. So the first little press is thicker and heavier, and I'm going to let it wear off because I don't want this just uniform. That looks fake. I want it to be somewhat, quite organic. So, see, I like there's a big, is that showing up? Let's see. You know what? I'm going to get a couple more on. And I'll get a close-up. And I'll just keep going until I wear it off the sponge and I need to reload. So we can see, got nice thick ones here, and then small. And all in all, it's just quite organic. So that's it. I'm gonna follow this through.
There you go.
Okay. So even up on this, can you see that? Up on this rim, I'm even just going right over it because we want this to look like it's all one big chunk of travertine. Nice, huh?
The whole thing is going to be?
Yeah.
Chunky.
Did I what?
Do you upstairs have to paint it or not?
I gotta glaze it still. Alright, the last, almost done. Now we're just gonna let this stuff dry. Okay, so now another wet sponge just for pliability. It's not dripping in water. Dipping it in my original glaze. So this is our fourth coat. First two coats of glaze, then a texture, and it's hard now. And now this is the fourth and final, which is just the glaze. So all I'm doing is I'm burnishing it in. And because I have so much movement underneath, maybe wanted it very subtle, that I don't think I'm getting a pattern, but if you do, you can tap it out. But I'm not seeing it. And this is really quick. See any swirls?
Mm-mm.
No.
All right. No, I don't see swirls.
Good. Good. Okay. So I'm gonna follow it out all the way down.
Okay.
Travertine floor that we needed to make it congruent with. And of course, our fireplace, which was what we were working off of. And there we go. Double deckers. All right, our texture. And our final glazing is applied, but see how it's too rough. It's almost hairy looking to me, but we want it again to look like this fire mantle, which is truly smooth to the touch. So, and you see how that pits and lines are white. So what we're gonna do here is it's time to sand. So I'm going to sand back this texture, and when I scuff it, it's going to reveal the white underneath. So you will see. So I'm just using a sanding block, and a little muscle. It's smoother, but yet it still has a light texture to it, but just revealing that white plaster Aquastone under is going to mirror that fireplace perfectly. Anytime you sand, wear a mask. I'm not. I forgot mine, and rather than slow down production and go get one, I'm kind of holding my breath, and then I'm breathing deep over there. It's not ideal, but you know. Let's see. That's a wrap. Quite the gratifying job. It was seriously an awesome job to do. I'm so gratified.